I have an ear infection and I can't finger it out.
Of course, that stupid sexual wordplay is gonna be a win, cause how could it not be? Also, the ad-lib of him yelling that he needs auto-tune is fucking hilarious. Cerebral palsy, three Zoloft, Saito Zoff, to Rico Suave. Look it up. That's a reference to the rapper Rico Suave, while he was talking about his alter ego, or Slim Shady, having cerebral palsy, which is a developmental disorder in the brain, which could potentially cause you to be fucked up later in life. Backpack full of packs on a black satchel, a knapsack, and a flask full of yak and Jack Daniels. I don't want to mention everything he said there, so I'll just give 10 wins for the rhyme scheme, both in this section and actually, you know what, throughout the entire song in general, because it's just crazy. But my dick's an acronym, because it stands for you. An acronym, for example, CIA, is basically a combination of letters that stand for a name, but if his dick stands for you, then that means he has a boner. Guess that's what the Molly and X do. Guess who the fuck am Molly and X to? Molly and X is a reference to the drugs Molly and Xanax, but it's also a near homophone in this context because he asked who he is laying next to. However, there's another layer on top of this line because a common side effect of Xanax use is memory loss, so he can't remember who he slept with the previous night, and that's why he's asking. But ever since D-Nice to the rescue, feel a fresh crew. That's a reference to the rapper D-Nice, but the phrase D-Nice is also the name of a hair salon in London, which is why he mentioned a fresh crew, because a crew cut is a hairstyle. I'm going in, like the Red Roof. Red Roof Inn. The Red Roof Inn is a chain, which, side note, I had never heard of before this song, and I actually just recently saw a Red Roof Inn for the first time. You don't like it, eat a cock till your jaw breaks. Call it caught between a rock and a hard place. Caught between a rock and a hard place is a common expression, basically meaning that you're in a tough situation. But hard place in this context also refers to a dick that is hard, or in other words, erect. Cause you're watching your heart race like a Scarface in a car chase, but the cops are in arcade, stuck inside of a Mario Kart race, stuck in saw blades. There were just so many bars right there that I don't even want to explain them all. So I'll briefly just mention that he name-dropped Saw, Mario Kart, Scarface, and holy fuck, I can't keep up with this dude. I'm driving them all crazy. Driving them all crazy means that he's making them all go insane, but drive in the mall crazy means that he's driving crazily in a mall. Yeah, fuck all those stupid people trying to cancel Eminem. Also, this chorus is actually pretty good, cause he's talking about how he's tone deaf, or in other words, he doesn't give a fuck what people think about him, so he just keeps going. Just like your funeral, I'm at your service. I'm at your service obviously means that he's willing to serve you, but a funeral is also known as a service, so he's at your service or at your funeral. Pockets on stuff like a taxidermist. Holy shit. Pockets on stuff is a reference to how rich he is, but taxidermied animals are basically stuffed corpses of animals. So this line has layers. When this chick Angela and her grandmother in a tan colored van pull up with a handful of Zans and a substantial amount of gang just to ask what my... I'm sorry, but I've got to give 3 additional wins for his insane propensity for telling a story within a song. Yeah, a leap into the deep end of the pool. I can show you where the dives are. The phrase dives are is a reference to dive bars, but he was also talking about jumping in the pool, which is known as diving, obviously. I know this spot, but it's so live, but I'm trying to get some head first, like a nosedive. Alright, so I have 2 things here. First, getting head is another way of saying receiving a blowjob, but also is a way of saying that you are nosediving, like he said. Second, that is No Life Shack. I am not kidding. That is an animated No Life Shack. In fact, there's a whole nother level to this, cause Shaq talked about how he wanted to go to the club with Eminem in his killer reaction, and he's currently standing in line at this club. Holy shit, there's layers. So when it comes to ass, bitch, I get behind like the Heimlich. Getting behind is a reference to anal sex, but the Heimlich maneuver is when you essentially force somebody to cough up something stuck in their throat, and to perform this maneuver, you have to get behind the person. Pushed her out the sidekick, and I flipped the little white bitch off like a light switch. He had a bunch of different uses of the word side throughout that section, but he also mentioned flipping off a white bitch like a light switch, because light switches are mostly white, and to turn them off, you flip the switch. And get offline with whining, this is just a rhyme, bitch. Fuck cancel culture. That's all I have to say. Does Bill Cosby sedate once he treats the cheesecake in a decent state? Bill Cosby bars. Y'all probably already know how Bill Cosby sedated women and, you know, that whole, situation. Anyway, that line was a bar. You think getting rid of me's a piece of cake? I'm harder than finding Harvey Weinstein a date. Harvey Weinstein was involved in some sexual abuse scandals, so I think it's safe to assume that finding him a date would be pretty difficult. And that's why they say I got more lines than Black Friday. Black Friday is the busiest shopping day of the year, as Paul Blart would like to remind you.
You're gonna pull up, left hip forward, placing your right hand on your away hip thusly, giving the illusion that you have a gun, which of course we both know you don't.
You heard of Chris Christopherson? Yeah. Well, I'm Chris Christopherson. That is just some nice wordplay with saying that he's pissed off. Bitch, I can make orange rhyme with banana. Banana. That is worth 5 wins, and I don't have to explain why. At the crib playing Fortnite with your grandma. Not gonna lie, that kinda makes me wanna try to play Fortnite with my grandparents. Can't touch this, but before I get the hammer, I should warn you I'm Thor-like in this manner. Holy fuck. Okay, so MC Hammer was the rapper who had that song that went like, you can't touch this. But he also mentioned Thor, the Norse god of thunder, who wields a hammer named, oh boy, I'm gonna fuck up this pronunciation, Mjolnir. Something like that, right? But the day I lose sleep over you critiquing Mia, I ever let you cocksuckers eat it, Mia, need to be a motherfucking pizzeria. Not only was that a clever way of saying that nobody's ever gonna be able to chew him out, but his pronunciation there was absolutely insane. Being dirt poured, filthy rich, still me, bitch, like a realtor. Holy shit. He just said that, despite his massive net worth, he's still real, like a realtor. Aftermath, bitch. Hope camps lit. We put out fire. Dre stamps it. Putting out fires is another way of saying that you're fixing problems. So if Dre stamps it, then he's essentially squashing the issue. But putting out fire also refers to how Eminem is releasing amazing music while Dre stamps it because he's the producer. Here comes Marshall, with no holds barred. Eminem's real name is Marshall, so he said Barshall because he's spitting bars. Bitch, I'm a hurricane, you're a blowhard, like your old broad. She's full of semen, like the Coast Guard. Alright, so semen is a double entendre for sperm and also sailors, because he mentioned being a blowhard like a hurricane, because a blowhard can refer to a blowjob, or someone who gives a blowjob, and in a hurricane, the wind blows really hard. Got a few priors. Priors, or in other words, prior charges, but also priors as in the tool that is similar to a crowbar. Down, yourself, that is a reference to Mozart, the famous composer, so it's a pretty self-explanatory bar. Out for the cabbage means that he's gunning for the money, but coleslaw contains cabbage. On top of this, he also mentioned how he's so raw, which connects back to the line about cabbage, but is also another way of saying that his bars are kind of blunt, and he doesn't beat around the bush. R.I.P. to King Von. That's respect.
What did you say? Oh, I can't hear you.
I can't understand your accent.
What I'm trying to say is I'm driving them all crazy.
Go crazy! Ah, go stupid! Ah, go crazy!